Russell's souped up 1979 Camaro V8 blazing hecasyllabics of class unconsciousness through the widow Angelica's open bedroom window, where she blesses herself three times before the ceiling opens and the light of ages enters with full orchestrated strings. Russell crushes a beer can in his hand, wipes a thick hand across his thick head. He's young and dumb and tattooed with flags and barbed wire and often cliched and grease and fingernails, black steel-toed machinist. He grabs a socket wrench, slides under the car on the concrete, leaving his boots kicking as he tries to turn something unseen, soft curses rising. His wife, Mariana, walks out of their front door, cradling their child, Joshua, in one arm. Sleepy-eyed, murmurous fidget. She is juke music, curls dark as the cup of coffee in her hand, delicate as rain-deep afternoons. Russell wheels out from under the car. He's tall, handsome as hell, you'd say, if you spent some time staring. Fire hydrant hard, concrete slabs for shoulders. His wife choreographs the light like laundry gently flapping between the houses on a string-strung line. She hands him his blue-toweled son, all eucalyptus-nosed, sniffling. Russell wipes his hand on his jeans, cradles his boy with one arm, keeps his greased hand off the towel, wraps his other arm to his woman, who grabs him by the back of the neck and kisses. Steam whistles in the kettle from Angelica's kitchen window. Stained glass, salt all over the shoulder for luck. Three spits in the pot. Check this. Months ago, I heard my neighbors fighting right after the baby was born. Russell slammed the Camaro door. Vroom, vroom, vroom. He drove hard into a January snowbank. Stepped out, fucking dead, fucking dead, fucking dead. As his wife stood in the doorway, shaking her head. He slipped and fell face down into the snow, stood up, white-faced and laughing. When to slip and when to fall. I heard their bed springs sing that night, pulling like tide. If death is a train, let it be late to the station. For it is April, syllables of unopened buds, the body unburdened as the widow Angelica, blue-scarved and humming, has descended now to turn on the hose, bending to water her crocuses, still closed palms.